there everyone, back with another video. In this video we will be learning the important thing that we need to learn whenever we are dealing with the loops. So that's what we call it as a loop control. So I'll just say loop control. So again guys, what do you mean by loop control? Now we need to control our the body of the loop however we need, right? So we can't let the body of the loop execute however it wants, right? So we need to write at some point of time, we need to control those loop and skip some parts in the loop and execute some kind of a tricky thing inside the body of the loop, right? So we need to hold on the exact body of the loop. So I'll just give you some scenario in order to understand what is a loop control. Of course guys, we need to understand two things over here. So the first thing is we need to understand a break statement, which we did in the switch statement while we are studying about the switch statement. So the second thing we need to study is continue. So we need to understand the keyword called as continue, which helps us to handle the loop smoothly. So now guys, in the previous lecture we have done with the loop for loop, and we have also got to learn about the complexity just like this with just increasing the condition, right? So I'll just change the condition. I'll just say to make it as 10, and then of course we'll be printing high 10 times inside with the help of this for loop. So now instead of doing this thing, what I'll be doing here in the body of this for loop is I'll just say console.log and I'll just print A. So now what's the output here guys? And as you can see guys, we are printing 1 to 10, right? So we are printing the value of A. So now in order to control this body of the loop with the help of break, let me give you some scenarios. Like I need to print just 1 to 5 and don't want the rest of the things printed just like 6 to 10 without changing the condition. Of course we can just change it to 1 to 5 with this condition here. Of course we'll get the things, but I don't need to just change the condition itself, but I need to handle the loop inside the body itself, not just changing the condition, right? So now how to print, I'll just save this and come back to the scenarios here. So now we are printing 1 to 10. How to print just 1 to 5 instead of printing 1 to 10 inside the body of the loop? We need to control our body of the loop such a way that it just prints 1 to 5 no matter what the condition here is, right? So even though we have 10 here, which is supposed to print 10, right? So we need to print 10, 1 to 10, right? So now what I'll be doing here is I'll be making use of break here, and then with the help of if condition, I'll just say if A is 5, then I'll just say break. That's it. So now guys, what do you mean by a break? If we use a break statement inside a for loop or any other loop, it will just terminate the loop entirely. That's it. It will just come out of the loop and execute the rest of the program. So now of course we don't have the rest of the program. I'll just say console.log and I'll just say this is outside, right? So this is outside of loop. Yeah, it's double O. Yeah. So now guys, now let me check the output. So now guys, as you can see, it has just printed 1 to 5, and at the last we have executed the rest of the program, right? So this is the body of the for loop, and if the A becomes 5, we are just terminating the body of the loop entirely and execute the rest of the program, and we got the thing here, right? So if I just change it to 6, so now we'll be printing 1 to 6 and the rest of the loop. That's it. The rest of the program. So yes guys, this is how we control the body of the loop, right? So we call it as a loop control with the help of break, right? So we use break usually to terminate the loop at some point of time with some conditions. So we can't use break without the condition, right? So we need to make sure that you use a condition to terminate a loop inside the body of the loop with the help of a break statement. So now guys, coming to the continue. So now guys, how do we use continue and what is the use of this? So let me explain you this. I'll just remove this off. I'll just comment this instead of removing. And now after printing the value of a, which will be, I guess, yeah, it's 1 to 10. It's 1 to 10. Now what I will be doing here is I'll just say if again the same kind of, if a is equal to 5, I will just say continue. That's it. So now what is the output here, guys? I'll just check the thing here. It's the same thing, right? So what's the use of this? Now guys, you need to understand that if I have something called as, let me say, I'll just say console over here. I'll just console.log, and then I'll just say inside of loop. So now let me check the output, guys. As you can see, first it will print the value of hi, and then it will check for the condition if a is 5. If it is so, we'll be continuing the loop, and if not, we will be executing this. We'll just printing inside of a loop after printing the value of i. As you can see in the output, it prints 1 inside of the loop, it's print 2 inside of a loop, and it goes on until 5. And as you can see here, guys, there is something going on here, right? So till 1 to 4, we have got 1 inside of a loop, 2 inside of a loop, and it all the way to 4. And inside of the loop. But if you notice with respect to 5, we are not getting inside of a loop, we are not executing this statement, right? So now here is the point. So if we use continue, the keyword continue, it just skips the rest of the body of the loop and go back to the again the next iteration of the loop, right? So it will just go back to the starting part of the loop over here and then make those changes over here with those variable, the test variables, and again start with the next iteration. So if the condition, so now in our case we have used if a is equal to 5, then we have said continue. So we are skipping all of the rest of the body of the loop, right? So we are not terminating the loop. We are just skipping the sum of the body of the loop and go back to the next iteration. So now in the next iteration, a becomes a 6, and now we'll be printing 6, and again the test condition in this if condition will be failing because a is now 6 and the continue will not be executed, and we will be executing the rest of the body of the loop, and now we got 6 inside of the loop all the way back to the 10 and the inside of the loop. And once we have done with the loop, we have executing this is outside of the loop. That's it, guys. So this is how we will be controlling the body of the loop with the help of break and continue. So we'll be using continue keyword in order to skip some of the parts in the loop, and we will be using break in order to terminate the loop, the entire loop, and come out of the loop. That's it. So this is the thing you need to understand about the break and the continue. So this is all about the loop control. So this is what we usually do in all the programming languages, not just in JavaScript, guys. Again, these are the concepts which will be mostly similar in all the programming languages. Yes guys, this is all about the loop control with the break and the continue. I hope that you have got a lot of information in this. I have explained you all about if and the break and the continue, and with this inside of the loop and the body of the loop and outside of the loop, right? So make sure that you subscribe to my channel, like, comment and share this, and it will be helping you as well, and you will be helping me just by subscribing to my channel. That's it, guys. I just want to subscribe, and because I have given you a lot of information right here in this course just for free, right? Yes guys, this is all about it, and I hope that I have made your day, and see you in the next video.